In last classes, we have discussed about different types of topics in this chapter. That different events happen. Events are steps of respiration process. What? Steps of respiration. Last class, we have discussed about first event, that is breathing. First event, that is breathing. What? Breathing. Process of inhalation and exhalation of air is the breathing process. Is the breathing. Okay. What are the important structures involved in breathing process? Actually, in our character, lungs. Lungs are main important organs. Lungs are the main important organs. They cannot take the oxygen or they cannot take the air from the atmosphere. They cannot take the air from the atmosphere and cannot release the air present in lungs. Because lungs are spongy in nature. Lungs are spongy. Lungs are spongy in nature. That is why they cannot push the They cannot push the air from the lungs. They cannot push the air from the lungs. That is why around the lungs some specialized structures are present. They are the important structures. The important one or diaphragm. Next, just go on. These two play very important role in breathing. Here, diaphragm and chest wall. These two parts the two pots confronting. Okay, two parts contain the logic. Due to kind of logic, due to presence of logic, due to presence of logic, contraction. Contraction and relaxation, relaxation of them are taken. Relaxation of stem are taking place of the cochlea by the mother. Next up, chest wall. Chest wall contains different muscles. Next up, ribs. Okay. What? Chest wall contains the muscles and ribs. Next, diaphragm means it is a an important it is an important muscle responsible for what? It is an important muscle responsible for the inhalation and exhalation. have the breathing. Here lungs are the very important organs. Lungs are the very important organs in respiratory system. Lungs are spongy in nature. They cannot push the air from the lungs. Okay, air from the lungs, and they cannot absorb the air from the atmosphere. Next, your diaphragm and another diaphragm and another important one is chest wall. These two play very important role in breathing process. Okay, two parts contain life. Two parts, diaphragm and chest wall contain the muscles. It's a very important one. Next, due to the presence of muscles, contraction and relaxation of the senses are taken care by muscles. These steps are taken by muscles. Chest wall contains the muscles, ribs, and small portion of the skin. Next, it is an important muscle. It is an important muscle responsible for the inhalation and exhalation. Okay, Okay, next term. Next, inhalation and exhalation. Actually, carbon dioxide is waste gas. It is present in exhalation. Carbon dioxide percentage is 4.4%. The normal atmospheric air, normal conditions, carbon dioxide is 0.03%. 0.03%. Okay, here what is the pathway of breathing process? Here, observe carefully. Pathway of the respiration. First important pathway of air. Pathway of air in respiratory system. Okay, after first nostrils, next nostril cavity, next pharynx or pharynx, next larynx, next trachea, after trachea bronchi, Next. Bronchioles. Bronchioles. Alveoli. Okay, this is the pathway of anything respiratory system. Respiratory system. Okay, first what happens? First, air is entered into the nasal cavity. Air is entered into the nasal cavity through nostrils. Through nostrils. Okay, nasal cavity. From the nasal cavity, air is entered into the next part, pharynx. Next part is pharynx. What? Pharynx. Next part is after pharynx, larynx. Larynx. Next, trachea. It is also called as windpipe. Okay, trachea. Windpipe. It carries the air from the mouth to lungs. Mouth to lungs. Or trachea. Next, after trachea, another important one is Other one is bronchioles. These are small branches of trachea. Next, bronchioles, those. What? Next, bronchioles. Understanding. Next, ultimately, air is entering into the alveoli or alveolus. Okay, observe carefully. Ultimately, from the alveoli, it enters into the blood. Through blood, oxygen is transported to each and every cell of the body. Each and every cell of the body. Observer. The other family, here North State. North State. Here Mount. This is the last of cavity. Next here carries. This is the epiglottis. This is the larynx. Here trachea. What? Trachea. Next. This one. These two are bronchi. Next, these branches are bronchioles. Here. Alveoli. What? Alveoli. Okay, this is the observable diagram of the respiratory system in human beings. Actually, how many nostrils are present? How many nostrils are present? Two nostrils are present. Through these two nostrils, air is entered into the nasal cavity. Inside of the nasal cavity, air is present. What? Air. What is the importance of this air? To prevent the entry of unwanted or waste material. Unwanted are waste material. Observably, what? Hey, prevent the entry of waste materials or dust materials. Dust. Into the dust, waste materials or dust into the respiratory tract. Next, inner lining is mucus layer, means inner side of the this nasal cavity is lined with mucus layer. What? Mucus layer. What is the importance of this mucus layer? Actually, mucus layer is wet in nature. That is why it traps the waste materials. Traps the waste materials and dust particles present inside of the air. Understanding? Next, another important one. Breathe in air. breathe in air, or temperature of the breathing air comes close to the temperature of the body. Okay, next, air is mixed with the moisture present in this nasal cavity, and air becomes soft. Okay, next, after nasal cavity, pharynx is very important junction, and it is the common passage or common part in digestive system and respiratory system. Okay, after pharynx, windpipe and esophagus means food pipe. Windpipe and food pipe are originated from the pharynx. Okay, that is why here dropping or junction is created. The art that junction pharynx dropping is controlled by a muscular clock-like structure that is the epiglottis. What is the function of the epiglottis? It prevents the entry of food material into the lungs. Okay, next part is larynx. It is also called as voice box. It has vocal cords. As air comes out of the lungs through the larynx or voice box, vocal cords are vibrated. Because of that vibrations, sound is produced. Next part is trachea. It is also called as windpipe. Okay, it is traveled from the neck. What is the function of the trachea? It carries the air into the lungs or towards the lungs. Remember up to here.
At the distance, various parts of means various parts of a moving body. When a body is moving in a different parts with a different type of motion, how to calculate the distance? How to calculate the distance covered by a body? In that, we learned already about when the body is moving in a translatory motion. When a body moving in a circular motion, when a body moving in a translatory motion, translatory motion means the body which is moving in a rectilinear motion, the body which is moving in a curvilinear motion, means the body which is moving on a straight line path, the body which is moving in a circular curved path, the body which is moving in a curved path. Understand? But also we learn the body which is moving in a circular path, in these three conditions, we already learned how to measure the distance covered by a body. And now coming to that, among that situations, what we are discussing to calculate the distance, now today we are going to discuss third situation or third case to calculate the distance covered by a body. So case three, what I am saying to you. Third situation, case three. Yes, we are going to discuss when a body is moving by making to and fro motion. When a body making to and fro motion means when a body is moving up and down. Let's talk about when your body is moving up and down. Means what I am saying. Body covers maximum height. How much it will cover? Let's round of size from A to Z. It is the maximum height, h. H meters, I will say that. H meters. Meter is a unit to measure the length, so it is a unit to measure the distance. Understand? Coming to what I'm saying to you, what I'm talking to you, a body projected upwards direction, projected upwards direction, thrown upwards direction. It covers the maximum height, it reaches maximum height. After the ball of body comes down, the body comes down. How much length it covers? Same of the height. So h meter. Same of the h meter. Means what we can say? The body covering a length to move upwards to come downwards. Means the total length covered by a body is how much more? H plus h. Means 2 times of the h. So what we can say here? Distance covered by a body. Distance covered by a body. Here nothing else what we can say? H meter plus h meter. So what happened? 2 h meter. 2 h meter. Understand? 2 h meter. Means if suppose the maximum height is covered by a ball is, I'm saying to you, 5 meters. It fails to come down also 5 meters. So total depth is covered by your body. This is for 2 into 5 meters. Our body is 10 meters. Of course, 5 plus 5, 10 meters. Our body what we can say 5 plus 5, 10 meters. How much length is covered towards the height? The same height should come to down. So the body covers 2 times of the same height, same length. So that's why the distance covered by the body in this situation is not equal to 0, and also it is not a negative sign. Understand? Not on that. So we will get means we have a syllabus for online test, distance and displacement. Distance and displacement is a test for online. Understand? Keep learning. So finish that. After finishing this distance to cover, we'll learn about displacement. What we learn about? Displacement. Let's learn that. Displacement. We already learned about distance with different characters, different properties of the distance, how to calculate the distance, what about the distance, how to measure the distance. Then as we learn to measure, to calculate the properties of the displacement. Okay? Coming to that. Displacement. What we are going to talk about? Displacement. What is the displacement? Displacement is shortest distance covered by a body. What I am saying to you, shortest distance covered by a body in a particular direction. In a particular direction, in a particular direction between final point means discovered the final point to the initial point. Initial point. What I am saying to you, shortest distance covered by a body. Shortest distance covered by a body is nothing as a displacement. That nothing we are writing that displacement. We are writing as a final point minus initial point. What we can say? Initial point. Final means where it was reached. Initial means where it was started. It was reached. And what we can say? Started. Reached, started. Understand? So the difference between the final point and initial point. The final distance covered by a body to the initial distance covered by a body. Suppose, example, what I am saying to you, this is the number of time what I am giving to you. The body starts journey from 2 and it reaches the maximum distance. What I am saying to you, what is 6 meters? I am giving this in meters. I am giving this in meters. Okay? Coming to the what I am saying, it started from 2 initial point, it reaches to the 5.6 meters. So, displacement generally, what I am saying, displacement is equal to 6 meter final point. Initial point is a 2 meter, what thing is a 4 meter? Shortest distance covered by a body. Shortest, just like some point say, how to calculate final position and initial position. Understand? So, shortest distance covered by a body. Shortest distance covered by a body. Let's have a talk something, one more example. Room corners. Room corners. There are 4 room corners. Is it? These are the 4 room corners. This is a room, this is one corner, this is one corner, this is one corner, this is one corner. Corner 1, corner 2, corner 3, corner 4. See there, a body starts in journey from second corner to second corner to. A body starts in journey. Initial point is the second corner. 2, it reaches to the third corner, again it reaches to the start to journey from third corner to. Fourth car. It reaches to the fourth car. See here, what I am saying to you, a body starts to journey from second corner of the room to fourth corner of the room. Then what is the displacement covered by a body? Displacement covered by a body means, suppose if I say this is a 3 meters, this is a 4 meters, I will say to you. Means we can't say 3 meter plus 4 meter is a 7 meter. It is not a displacement. We are saying displace, we are not saying distance, we are saying about displacement. So distance means the length covered by a body. Length covered by a body 3 meter and 4 meter total 7 meter, that's the final. Then displacement is what? Shortest distance covered by a body between final point to the initial point. So, shortest distance is the longest distance. Now, shortest distance is what? From C2 to C4, which is the shortest path, to eliminate the C3 path. So, this is the displacement. What is this? Displacement means shortest path. What we can say? Shortest path. One more example we can say. Suppose, see, this is one thing we have to learn. A body moving in a circular path with radius r. By this direction, the body is moving from 1 to A. See, the length covered by body by this we already find. Then what is the displacement? Shortest distance to reach the final. So, OA is the shortest distance. OA is the shortest distance. So, the distance should be short. Should measure between final point to the initial point. Final point to the initial point. That we are saying displacement. What we are saying about that? Displacement. Understand? So, if you have to measure displacement, then you will not suffer into placement. Coming to that, why I'm saying to you. So final point where the spiritual point is nothing as displacement. See here, it is following a particular direction. How like a person walking, suppose according to India map, this is the India map direction. Topmost is a great Himalayas are located. So great Himalayas are located as north. The ocean Hindu is located at the bottom of the Indian map. So that's why what we can say this is the south. Indian Ocean is located at the south, and the Bay of Bengal is located at east, and Arabian Ocean is located at west. So by India map, okay, direction of India. So coming to the column says a person. Listen carefully. A person moving or traveling towards the direction of east. Towards the direction of east. A person walking 3 meters towards the east direction, and he took a direction towards the south. Towards the south, east, south. Then what is the shortest distance covered by a body from east to south? This is the shortest distance. So displacement. It is not a displacement. See here, displacement is following a particular direction. Displacement is following a particular direction. Means displacement following both direction and magnitude. Displacement following both direction and magnitude. The physical quantity which is following both magnitude and direction, those physical quantities we can call vector quantity. What I am saying to you, note. The physical quantity which is following both direction and magnitude. Direction and magnitude. Then we can call that physical quantity is nothing as what we can call that vector quantity. Which are that? Can you say that the physical quantity which is following both the direction and the magnitude, then we can call that physical quantity what? That nothing else. We can call that physical quantity is nothing as vector quantity. So what I am going to say here, the displacement is a vector quantity. Displacement is a physical quantity. Displacement is a following both direction and magnitude. Both direction and magnitude. So it is a vector quantity, which is a displacement is a vector quantity. Displacement, it is showing by yes bar arrow mark because of vector quantity. Okay, shortest distance covered by a body is displacement. No, distance showing by yes, displacement showing by yes arrow mark. So because of vector quantity, so note on that. Now finish that. Coming to that. So what we learn about displacement? Displacement is a sharpest distance covered by a body in a particular direction between two points. Same two points, both are final point and initial point. The displacement covers between a measure between from initial point to the final point. From initial point to the final point. Coming to that, what are the units to measure the displacement and how to measure the displacement? Let's calculate that. Coming to that, displacement. Displacement is showing by F arrow mark because of vector quantity. Vector quantity means we follow both magnitude and direction. Follow both magnitude and direction. Okay, coming to the what I say, shortest, it is a shortest distance covered by a body. So distance is measured by meters in SI system. So it is nothing as distance measures, so that's why displacement is also the same of the units of distance. So what we can say, displacement is measured by meters in SI unit. In SI unit means what we can say, that is a MKS, international system, which is that meters. Whereas centimeters in what we can say, CGS system. CGS system, which is that centimeter is a unit to measure the displacement in CGS system. Understand? So what we observe, we can conclude that both we can say, so the both distance and displacement are both measured by same units. Understand? And also what we learn, distance is a scalar quantity, displacement is a vector quantity. Distance is a scalar quantity, displacement is a vector quantity. Understand? Coming to talk about how to measure the displacement. How to measure the displacement. Let's calculate that and no doubt. Yeah, coming to that. How to calculate the displacement? How to calculate the displacement? Okay, let's calculate displacement same as before. What? How we measure? How we calculate distance? Yes, or okay? If a body moving with the translatory motion, okay, translatory motion. See that if it is moving with the translatory motion, what we can say? It's moving translatory motion. How much? The body is moving in a straight line path. A body moving in a straight path. Straight path means rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion. Okay. Coming to that example one, I am going to talk to you. This is the body moving from A to B. A to B. So it is a 0 meter and it is a 5 meter. Okay? So displacement covered by a body. Displacement covered by a body in a rectilinear motion. In a rectilinear motion. Means through straight road or straight path. Through straight path. Means what we can say here, displacement is equal to final point minus initial point. Final point minus initial point. Displacement is equal. Final point is a B and initial point is a A. So final point measurement is a 5 meter, initial point measurement is a 0 meter. So what we can say here? 5 meter. What we are going to say here? 5 meter. Displacement is a 5 meter. And the same way what I am saying here, distance also I am going to measure. Distance is equal to total length covered by a body. So 5 meter. So what we can say here, therefore we can say displacement is equal to the distance. What we can say here? Displacement is equal to the distance in straight path. In straight path means rectilinear motion. What we can say? Rectilinear motion. In rectilinear motion, what happened? Displacement is equal to the distance in a straight path. Hold on. Coming to that, second situation in case one, when a body moving in a curvilinear motion, means when a body moving in curved path, then what is the displacement covered by a body and distance covered by a body? Coming to talk about that example. Coming to that, what I'm saying, the body moving in a curved path. What I'm saying, in a curved path. Means, what we can say, curvilinear motion. Curvilinear motion. Okay? Curvilinear motion. Coming to the point, I'm saying to you, example, a body moving in a semicircular path, semicircular path. See here, what I'm giving to you an example, semicircular path. Okay, this is a center with the radius r, semicircular path with radius r centimeter. See what I am going to say to you, the body moving by this direction from A to B. Then what is the distance covered by body and displacement covered by body? We are talking about displacement, so we can go with the displacement covered by your body. Displacement covered by a body. Displacement covered by a body in semicircular path. With the radius r centimeter is equal to, what we can say here, see, displacement is equal to, what we can say, displacement is equal to final point minus initial point. Means what we can say here, final point minus initial point, displacement is equal to, final point is a B and initial point is a A. See now, it is starting from 0, if there is R plus R, total is a 2R. Total is what? 2R centimeter. Means one diameter. Total is a 1 diameter. So we know that diameter is equal to R is equal to D by 2. Okay? So what we can say here, final point is a 2R minus 0. So 2R centimeter, shortest distance covered by your body. Is it or not? By this moving, but it is a longest distance, it is shortest. So displacement is a 2R centimeter, shortest distance covered by your body. If R is equal to 7 centimeter, then displacement is equal to 2 into 7 centimeter, so 14 centimeter. Displacement covered by your body, shortest distance. And similarly, distance is equal to, how do we solve that? Half of the otherwise what we can find, this is a pi r meter v by 2 centimeters. Then what I am saying to you, distance is equal to 22 by 7, pi value, r is a 7 centimeters. 7 months are 7 months are, so 22 centimeters. Compare those two, displacement and distance. What happened? Distance is greater than the displacement. What we can show, we can say, distance is greater than the displacement. What we can say here, therefore, distance is always is greater than to the displacement. Before we learn, displacement is equal to the distance. Otherwise, displacement is equal to the distance. So we can say displacement is equal to the distance. Displacement is smaller than to the distance, or distance is greater than to the displacement. No doubt that. So from that what we learn, distance, displacement, we are comparing here. Distance in one situation is equal to the displacement. In another situation, distance is greater than to the displacement. Okay? By above that we can write distance is greater or equal to the displacement. Distance is greater or equal to the displacement. There is a chance to raise the question when distance and displacement both are equal. When a body moving in a straight line path, the distance and distance covered by a body in a straight line path both are same. The distance and displacement both are same when the body covers on a straight line path. When the body moving in a straight line path, only in the straight line path, only in the rectilinear motion, the distance and displacement both are same. How much distance covered by a body is equal to the much displacement covered by a body. But remaining all situations, distance is always greater than the displacement. Means what we can say, distance never will become zero. Displacement sometimes will zero. That we will discuss in the next situations. We will discuss in the next situations. Understand? No doubt about it. Next we will talk about circular motion. Circular motion. And then after, when a body is moving, perpendicular, projecting perpendicular to the earth. When it is moving upward direction, then what is the distance and displacement covered by a body? When a body is moving in a circular path, then what is the distance displacement covered by a body? Then after, we will compare the distance and displacement, what are the similar quantities and unsimilar. And also, we will discuss some problematic questions on distance and the displacement. Then we will make a grand prize to learn to prepare for online test. Okay? Finish with those. So, remain situation, we learn in the next class. Remain situations, we learn in the next situation. We may have more to learn. Okay, see you in the next class. Have a good evening.